Hey there, Jason here with AV Pro Edge and Murideo, and today is going to be a really cool video. We're going to take a look at my calibration kit, and I'm going to show you all the bits and pieces that I use to calibrate a video system. Okay, now the first thing I want to talk about today is my computer. This is a normal Windows computer. This is what I'm going to use to run Caliman. Now, you don't necessarily have to use a Windows computer. If you are a Mac user, you can use Bootcamp or Parallels or any of those Windows emulators on your Mac to run Caliman. That's okay. Okay, now we'll dive into the hardware a little bit. Okay, now the first piece I want to talk about . This is my spectroradiometer. This is the meter that I use to profile my other meter so I can get the calibration done much faster. But being able to use the spectroradiometer, I know my calibrations are gonna be super, super accurate. This spectroradiometer is made by a company called Jenny. This is the model number 1511. I did do a little modification to this when I ordered it. I was able to get the resolution a little bit tighter than how it normally comes from the factory, which is really important when you're measuring certain display devices, especially laser phosphor-based projectors, such as some of the new Sonys and JVCs that are out there. So this is really the tool that's given me the most accuracy when I do my calibration, but it's not the fastest meter in the world. I do have another meter that'll help speed things up, and we'll talk about that one next. The next piece we're gonna look at is my second meter. And I like to use the second meter to really speed things up. So there may be situations where you're in a dedicated theater room, or maybe there's a TV on the wall. So we're gonna use this meter. This is called a Klein. Model number is a K10. This is really what helps me get through the calibration in a timely manner. I could do the entire calibration with the Jenny, but because of its speed, it would take a long time. So I like to use the Klein to really get things moving quickly. So the Klein does come with its own nice little tabletop tripod. So if you are gonna put the Klein meter right in front of the TV, maybe on a TV stand or something like that, then you can use the little tabletop tripod that it comes with. And this will give you about a foot, maybe 12 inches or so to play with. You can adjust the height and whatnot. But this does come with the Klein. And then also, I have a normal tripod as well. Now, the good thing about this is you can buy any tripod. The threading on the bottom of the 2 meters, on any meter for that matter, they're all standardized threads, just like on a camera. So in situations where I'm in a dedicated theater room, maybe there's no place to put the small tripod in front of the TV, but I do just have a normal photography tripod as well. I wanted one that was really lightweight and stuff, especially flying and things like that. I don't want my bag to be too heavy. So I did kind of spring a little bit, get a nice carbon fiber, lightweight tripod. But multi-purpose, I can use this for my photography as well. Okay. Next on the list, we're going to take a look at my signal generator. This, of course, is a Murideo 6G. And for instances where I also have to do some troubleshooting, I also have a Murideo 6A as well. I do keep a couple of bits in this case that help me throughout the calibration. Number one is a just standard, everyday USB hub. You know, by the time I have a meter plugged in, my generator plugged in, I also like to use a mouse. I don't like the trackpad on my laptop. So I do like to use the USB hub to hook up multiple things to the laptop. Also, I've got a short HDMI cable. You know, those instances where I'm working right next to the TV, I've got a short HDMI cable in here, the 2 meter HDMI cable. So I can hook up the generator to the TV to do the calibration. It's also a good idea to have one of these with you too. This is a little HDMI coupler. You know, sometimes the cable management's really tight behind the source, so I'll pull the HDMI cable out of the source, and I'll just use my coupler and plug into my HDMI cable to hook into the generator. And now I'm connected to the TV without having to tear the cabinet apart or tear the rack apart. Now I do also have this adapter. This adapter is for doing automatic calibration or autocal on Samsung TVs. This is USB to serial and then serial to 3.5 millimeter. Now, if you are doing autocal on Samsung TVs, I do want to point out one thing. You can't just buy any generic USB to serial adapter. It does have to be a specific one. There's actually a couple that work with Caliman. And if you want to know exactly which ones those are, check the website, the Portrait Displays website. They do have the specific model numbers listed there for Samsung TVs. And then of course I've got my power supplies. The last thing I want is to have a dead generator when I show up to a client's home or show up to do a job. And then also I've got my micro USB cable. This is a little bit longer than the one that comes with the Murideo generator, just because, you know, usually when I'm at a job, you know, I might need a longer one. So I've got a short one and a long one just to be safe. The next thing I want to point out is I do carry a long HDMI cable with me. This is a Bullet Train 20 meter AOC cable. This comes from our long haul series. This is a hybrid fiber optic copper HDMI cable. One thing I do want to point out about these, if you are going to use one of these, fantastic cable, by the way. I've run this thing 20 meters, 30 meters, comes in 40 meters even. It is a directional cable, so the head ends are labeled display and source. If you are going to use one of these, just make sure that you have the ends on the right end, or you run into some problems. Now, sometimes you end up having to work on the projector or the TV, and it's really far away from the rack or from the sources. So I do also have this nice handy USB extension cable. Now, one thing I do want to point out about this, this isn't just like a really generic inexpensive one. This was a little bit nicer one. I think this one was made by, this is a Trip Light. One thing I do want to recommend, if you are going to use a USB extension, some of these meters do tend to draw a lot of current. So don't just use an off the shelf, no name, USB cable. Go for an active USB cable. I've seen them from Belkin and Trip Light, of course. So I like to have one of those with me as well. Now, I'm not always doing audio calibration, but as a courtesy with a lot of my clients, I do like to, you know, at least check their speaker levels for them. A lot of people now will use like an SPL meter as an application on their phone. I still carry around the old handy dandy Radio Shack SPL meter. This thing is great. A lot of people have this meter. I use it. Quite a bit. I see this meter all the time when I go to concerts and things like that. It's a very, very popular SPL meter. I also have a device called a Syncorn 2. This is a great little device that we sell at AV Pro. This will let me analyze and fix any audio delay issues. So, you know, if you have that call from the customer and they say, you know, the lips don't match up with the voice, this little device will help you measure how much delay there is. And then you can adjust the audio video delay in your AVR, in your matrix switch, or any other device in the system that might have an audio delay. I do also have this ambient light meter. This is something that you'll see a lot in the photography world, commonly referred to as a lux meter. So this will let me walk around the room and analyze anywhere in the room where there might be too much light, not enough light. You know, in an ideal situation in a theater room, of course, we want to have no light at all if we can help it. So I do like to use this meter sometimes to kind of walk around the room and figure out, you know, if there's any light coming in the room, where the curtain should go, how much light we need to block, those types of things. So that comes in handy as well. Then a couple other things, of course, that just make your life a little simpler. An extension cord. I also carry with me a little, you know, power strip. Now, there are some cases where I have to connect directly to a projector or a television to do auto-cal or to communicate with the TV or the projector. And sometimes you're not in situations where the Wi-Fi is very reliable, or maybe there's no Wi-Fi at all. So I do carry around a long category cable with me. That way, if I do have to direct connect to a projector or to a television, I have a nice long cable here to be able to do that. Now from here, the rest of my kit is just demo material and movies and things like that, stuff to show the customer after the calibration's done, and also some test discs. Now, we live in a world today where not everybody has a Blu-ray player, and I totally get that. So I do have a lot of my test patterns and my demo content also on a thumb drive. So in my little book here, like I said, I've got a bunch of different test discs, the old ISF HDTV calibration wizard disc, the Spears and Munsell discs, Ryan Masiola's Diversified Video Solutions disc, the old Digital Video Essentials disc, the old QDEO disc, has some good motion test patterns on it. And then just some movies I like to show customers that have really good video, really good audio. The Art of Flight, really good 1080p. The Matrix, very good Dolby Vision. You know, so you're gonna wanna have a nice collection of demo material to show the customer. I like to have some animated stuff, stuff from the BBC like Planet Earth. These things always look very, very good when the TV's calibrated. And I did just recently pick up a couple of new discs. The new 2019 DTS demo disc, they were handing these out at CEDIA, so I made sure to grab one of those. Same thing with the IMAX Enhanced disc. Very, very good disc, by the way, especially if you're showing off black levels. There's some scenes on this disc where you have stars in the background with a black, you have a black background with stars and the earth and the moon and things. Really, really good demo content on here. And then the brand new Spears & Munsell Series 3 disc. This is HDR, SDR, Dolby Vision. Great disc. And then I did just pick up a new movie, Brightburn. Great black levels, great Dolby Atmos, really, really good demo material. One thing I do want to mention, when you're doing calibrations on Samsung TVs, sometimes you need to do things like turn on the Cal Day and Cal Night modes. And you can't do that a lot of times with the remote that the TV comes with. So I do like to carry a Samsung remote with me, one that actually has numbers on it. That way if I need to access the service menu to turn on the day and night modes, I can do that. And then I do also like to carry around a microfiber towel. Just as a courtesy, I like to wipe down and clean the customer's TV. Just take that extra step and show that you really care about the system. And then last but not least, I do also carry around with me a little Murideo CIE diagram. This helps me explain to the customer about standards and white points and things like that. So I always like to have these in one of these in my backpack to kind of help me show the customer what the calibration is all about. And that's really it, guys. That's everything that I use in my kit to calibrate TVs and video systems. So hope you found this interesting. Give this video a like and leave your comments down in the bottom. Let us know what you like to use in your calibration kit. Thanks for watching.